Rocco Santomaro taking on Jose Estrella. And there you see being led out by Shane Mosley Jr. Shane Mosley Jr. actually gonna fight later on tonight. And when we do have a moment, let's catch our breath here. Let's reset.
Yeah.
Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, Steve Kim, directed by Will Wright, David and Scott Tachor, Executive Vice Presidents. Appreciate everybody on Ring TV, Yip TV, and also on Film On. When we come back, we'll have Rocco Santomaro and Jose Estrella. Zorna Casino inside the event center, getting ready for Rocco Santomaro and Jose Estrella. There you see Jose Estrella.
To go six rounds of featherweight action, introducing first, finally out of the blue corner. Wearing black with silver, he weighed in officially 125 pounds. His professional record, 14 victories, 9 defeats, 1 draw with 10 wins by way of knockout from Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico. Here is Jose, Mr. Hollywood Estrella. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wears tiger print trunks and weighed in officially 119 pounds. In 12 bouts, he has 12 victories, no defeats, 1 knockout to his credit. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, here is the SoCal Kid, Rocco Santomaro. Referee Ray Corona in charge of the action.
Let's go, gentlemen. Let's go. Mouthpiece. Right here is good. Stand up straight. Right there is good. Touch gloves. God bless.
A couple of fighters who are really hyper.
Yeah.
Rocco Santomaro of Argentinian and Uruguayan descent. He's in the red corner, the Tecate corner. Trained by Mosley. Shane Mosley, Jack Mosley, the second assistant to the family affair with the Mosleys against Hollywood Estrella. Jose Estrella, a veteran. He's 26 years old. And he's 14-9-1, been a pro since 2008. Of course, usually the Mexican fighters turn pro on their 16th birthday. Rocco Santomaro, 12-0 with one KO. Las Vegas, Nevada, originally grew up in Esperia, California, not too far from us here in Indio, California. He said he was just around the wrong crowd, decided to dedicate himself to boxing, went to Las Vegas, and that's where he's been. This is time between Las Vegas and Esperia, but he calls Las Vegas his home. The back of his trunk says Cecilia. That's the name of his 8-month-old daughter. Hollywood Estrella. How does the kid from TJ have a nickname with Hollywood? Well, the back of his trunk say Hollywood Beauty Supply. That's where he works.
I see.
His nickname, it comes from where he works because they sponsor him. He didn't have a nickname. They said, well, we're just going to call you Hollywood. Never been to Hollywood, but he calls himself Hollywood Estrella.
Now, he's well-traveled, though.
Yeah.
26 years old, and he's a young veteran. He's actually weighed in at the featherweight limit, whereas Rocco Santomaro came in just a pound over the bantamweight division. I think the extra weight should help Estrella. He's definitely the more relaxed, more settled down of the two fighters.
Doug, I think this is interesting. If you look at the record, certainly Santomaro has a shinier record, but Estrella, I think, is a more seasoned guy. He's lost 4 in a row, but fighting the likes of Diego De La Hoya and Oscar Negrete should not be overmatched here tonight.
And yeah, he definitely has the edge and experience.
Thank you. Opening round scheduled for six. Bethel Duran, Steve Kim, and Doug Fisher. And Steve, in that corner for Santa Mora is the Mosley clan.
Yeah, Shane Mosley is now a boxing lifer. I think we saw that coming about 20 years ago, Doug. But
yeah.
He's still fighting, and he's in the corner training various fighters. In fact, helped out Curtis Stevens not too long ago as he made a foray into the BKB. And we will see Sugar Shane Sr. in the corner of his son later on tonight.
I think one of the jobs that Mosley is going to have between rounds with Santa Moro is just calming him down.
Yeah.
He needs to settle down a little bit. Came in with a lot of energy. He's loading up a little bit too much, and he's in with a very experienced, well-traveled opponent here who's going to catch him between those haymakers.
Estrella landed two good left hooks to the body there. Certainly, Santa Moro, the way he reacted, I think he certainly felt it.
Let's see what the highlight package is for this fight.
He's taught me how to get leverage on my shots, a leverage that I didn't have before, and a little bit harder. Just some really technical, advanced moves, very advanced moves. It's amazing. The amount of knowledge he has is ridiculous. I mean, it blows me away every time he tries to teach me something new. It's mind-blowing because it's something different for me. It's not what I'm used to.
And there you see the Mosley, Shane Mosley. You know, most trainers stand in front of you and give you instructions. Shane, well?
Visual aids. He's going to demonstrate exactly. And what he's telling Santa Moro is get off at angles.
Yeah.
When you punch, slide to either side.
And in the background is Jack Mosley, who for years trained his son, came up with his own boxing style, power boxing.
I remember that.
Power boxing?
Power boxing, which basically box, but throw a lot of hard shots while you're doing so.
And for us young folks don't remember this, when Shane and his father were working together, power boxing. That's a Shane Mosley term?
Yeah. Yeah, see, I think Jack tried to have that trademark.
Well, if Pat Riley could get three-peat,
there you
trademark that.
Now, what I remember, Stephen, you probably remember from the L.A. Boxing Club, is Jack would grab a medicine ball and just press his son, and his son would get off at all kind of angles while backing up and landing with a lot of power. In some ways, that worked better with Shane than working him with mitts.
So instead of doing mitts, he was doing...
He would hold a medicine ball, the heaviest medicine ball, like a 20-pound medicine ball, and have his son... punch it. Maybe
and
not
guys,
20 pounds,
yeah,
but like
guys,
10 pounds.
Let me just say this. That is not something he invented.
Right.
Jack Blackburn, who trained Joe Louis, one of the great leverage punchers of all time, actually used to do drills like that. But, you know, like you look at Santa Moro, power you are born with. You cannot teach. I mean, 12 fights in with one knockout, that basically suggests to you he is what he is in terms of his punching power.
Which is why I think he's loading up a little bit too much with his punches. And when you do that and you're not a puncher, and I tell you what, Steve, I scored the first round for Estrella. I just thought that he was the more composed fighter in there, landed the cleaner punches, was the better boxer.
Doug, I thought the round was very even. I thought the last 20 seconds, I thought the Mexican pressed him with two hard left hooks to the body. I gave the advantage to Estrella 10-9 like you did.
Jose Lamberto Estrella from Tijuana, Mexico. He's in the black trunks. He fought three times last year against Diego De Loya, was stopped in the fourth. Oscar Negrete stopped in the sixth. That was one where the doctor stopped him. And Carlos Carlson, he was stopped in the eighth. The last two fights, he fought at 119 and 117. Talking to Estrella before that, like, what about those weights? He goes, I struggled to get down to it. He goes, if I have to and the money's right, I'll go back to it. But this is more of a comfortable weight for him right now.
I can see it.
Difference.
Yes, I can see it. I think it was good that he was over 120 pounds. Yeah, fighters need to... They need to be able to fill their body in there, you know, and you can't, you can dry out only so many times, as, you know, Randy Caballero has found out and other fighters. At some point, you're going to hit the wall with making a certain weight, and if you make it, you don't feel like yourself in the ring, or sometimes you hit the wall and you can't make the weight that you thought you could make.
Randy Caballero and Frankie Gomez coming up later on the night. Caballero, the main event, the undefeated fighter, former IBF champion. And Frankie Gomez from East LA, also undefeated, 19-0, coming your way later, as is Hector Tanahata Jr., a nice prospect, 19-year-old from San Antonio, and Shane Mosley Jr. But right now, we got Rocco Santomuro against Jose Hollywood Estrella at the Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino in Indio, California.
right now, yes. Absolutely, yes.
And welcome back to the Resort and Casino. The music is down. That means I can finally hear myself a bit. Oh, the voice. That is Bethel Duran, Rocco Santamuro. Against Jose Estrella, Bethel Duran, Steve Kim, Doug Fisher. Thank you for joining us tonight. Wherever you're watching us, under the direction of Will Wright and his entire crack staff here at Indio, California. David and Scott Cho, Executive Vice President and Vice President for the digital side of Golden Boy Promotions. Nice evening.
Low blow. Yeah, left hand under the belt line, landed by Estrella. Santamoro needs to be really careful after this break. Estrella is looking to catch him in between some of those wide shots.
Doug, if you're Estrella, you have to like the way this third round's playing out, because right there inside chest to chest, and Santamoro's giving up his height and his reach, and he's been very effective with that left hook downstairs.
He's not just giving up his height and his reach, Steve. He's over-committing to his punches.
Santamoro in the tiger stripe shorts is 5'7". Estrella, 5'2"-ish.
Yeah, he's a little guy, but he knows how to fight. And he's not going to be intimidated by an unbeaten record.
And there he is. Tell him, come on. This is a different. Estrella is a fighter, a veteran journeyman at the age of 26 that we've seen him. But this is the fourth time that I've seen him, Doug. I think you also for you. But he has a different kind of attitude about himself. Like a very, he's confident in there. Unlike the last time when he was up against Diego De La Hoya, Oscar Negrete.
He knows that there are levels to unbeaten prospects.
You're saying Diego, there's levels to this.
Yeah, there's levels to this. Negrete and Diego De La Hoya were decorated amateurs that brought a lot of experience just from the amateurs into the professional ranks. Santamoro, I don't think so. I don't think he had that kind of extensive amateur background, and you could tell he's still learning how to just be comfortable in the ring.
Beto, not all undefeated records were created equally, as again, Estrella pounds another left hook to the body. I think one of the things you mentioned, Doug, is if you're going to be a speedy boxer puncher that's going to get in and out with quick combinations, one thing I noticed about Santamoro, he really does clench his fists in his face and really tries to bite down and punch hard instead of trying to punch fast.
Rocco Santamoro, his last bout, Memorial Day of 2014. But it's been a while for him. Maybe shaking off that ring rust, and that was a decision that went 8 rounds against veteran Daniel Cuate Quevedo. Quevedo came into that fight with a losing record, so it's been a while. He changed management, did Santamoro, changed trainers. So he's trying to get back in here, so you can see the anxiousness as they clash heads there.
And I appreciate his enthusiasm. I'm sure he wants to show his new trainer.
Oh, there's a nasty Hall of cut on the top of the head.
High on the right head, the right side of his scalp.
We're going to stay here. The doctors are already on the apron. Gonna check this one out. Santamoro and Estrella. But a clash of heads, a nasty, there it is, on the side of the head. For Rocco Santamoro, his cut man Rudy Hernandez immediately going to work in the corner of Rocco Santamoro.
That's a nasty gash. It doesn't look like it's bleeding directly into the eye, but at least Steve Santamoro has a veteran cut man in Rudy Hernandez. And let's see what led to this clash of heads. I don't think that was from a punch. Estrella is also dealing with the cut.
The cut on Estrella, Ray Corona, the referee, came over and told Estrella, that's from the headbutt.
Yes.
Your cut from the accidental headbutt. As Rudy Hernandez has that cut under control in the corner of Santamoro. Doctors stood up right away. Now the doctors are checking out Estrella. We got some blood here.
I'll say this, guys. Halfway through this sixth rounder, you've got to like your chances if you're Estrella. You're landing on him. You're not getting outboxed. You're allowed to get inside, and you're letting your hands go. I thought he had a really good end to round number three.
I scored round three for Estrella.
Ditto.
I have him up 2-1, as a matter of fact.
The Tijuana fighter. When you're, Steve, you said it. The undefeated records are different.
Yeah.
And the fourth round is brought to you by YipTV. Watch live TV from around the globe, including these live Golden Boy fights. Sign up today at YipTV.com. So if you're Tijuana, si me está mirando desde Tijuana, donde trabaja el Hollywood Estrella, saludos. Su peleador está peleando bien bonito ahorita. Hollywood Estrella in there with Rocco Santamuro. He's from Argentina and Uruguayan descent. Hello to our friends.
Look at how composed Estrella is. And it's bad news for Santamuro when a guy who's 5'2" with a shorter reach can land a huge right hand to the ear that Estrella did about 25 seconds ago.
And hello to everybody watching us. Of course, Mr. Boxing Guru, the Ace of SoCal, title fight. Joshua something, good Twitter name. Appreciate you watching us, and you're watching Estrella and Rocco Santamuro mix it up here at the Fantasy Springs Resort and Casino. But what I was trying to say, when you're undefeated, you have a certain confidence.
Yeah.
And when you're a journeyman, especially, you know, the Mexican fighters don't care what your record is. They don't respect what your record is.
You know, Beto, there's a train of thought. You're not a real Mexican fighter until you lose at least three times before your 25th birthday. But also, you know, the bottom line is when you are a guy like Santamuro, a lot of the times, there's two things that are very deceiving in boxing. That's a high knockout percentage early and undefeated records. Because quite frankly, if you have the correct and proper matchmaking, you can get to 30-0 without really showing all that much as a professional prize fighter.
Hollywood Estrella in the black trunks. Rocco Santamuro now living in Las Vegas. Wearing the red Everlast gloves. It was a clash of heads in the last round. Accidental headbutt was ruled by referee Ray Corona. As a slip is ruled. Indio, California, nice sized crowd on a Friday night. Working our way towards Frankie Gomez. And some very old fees. And then Randy Caballero, Ruben Garcia. Stop. We're done with five in Indio.
Estrella measuring Santamuro for a right cross that landed right to Santamuro's ear. Best punch of round four. And he's on the hunt in this round. Santamuro trying to establish his jab, Steve, but just kind of pawing, just kind of putting it out there most of the time.
Yeah.
Sometimes he snaps it.
Certainly not a stick. It's not certainly a type of Sergey Kovalev jab that we saw last week. And with that, Estrella is able to get inside and breach that airspace. And you see Shane Mosley seems to be telling him, keep your distance, control him with the left hand. But quite frankly, he might be asking his fighter to do something. Quite frankly, he may not be able to do.
He's asking Santamuro to fight like he did. Shane would often paw with his jab and then come over with a monster right. But Shane was a power puncher. Santamuro does not have the kind of physical strength and punching power that his trainer had.
Santamuro does not use a stool. He stays standing between rounds. And this fifth round is brought to you by the new Pixie app. Pixie, live curiously. Rocco Santamuro, 12-0 with only one KO. That was back in 2013, a fight that was in Uruguay. His opponent, Jose Estrella, 14-9-1. And after four rounds, how do you have it, Doug?
I have Estrella up 3-1. The only round that I've scored for Santamuro was round two, and even that was a competitive round.
Doug, I'm right with you. I have the exact same score, I think, with 6 minutes to go. I think Santamuro's undefeated mark is on the line.
Estrella coming into this bout had over 100 rounds professionally, 103 to be exact. Santamaro had 52. Estrella, this kind of fight is what he likes. Remember the first time we talked to him when he fought Diego De Loya last July, he said, I like to stay in the middle and just mix it up with people. Well, he mixed it up with a beast like Diego De Loya and was stopped in the fourth round.
Oh, good right hand landed by Hollywood Estrella.
Goes back to the body. Estrella coming in, trying to get the upset. Upstairs, good left hook, body work. Hollywood Estrella landing a good right
body shot.
Hand. Uppercut from Hollywood. The Tijuana fighter is feeling himself right now. Shaking his head, looking into the corner, gives himself a nod. In the black trunks is Hollywood Estrella. So you can have a couple stars on the back. Better come in and a little shine. That's what he's doing here in this round.
Well, yeah, he's shining.
Well, Beto, keep this in mind. Despite the 9 losses, Estrella is the one who has 10 knockouts. So no matter how flawed his record is, he has shown in the past to have a little bit of pop.
And he's been in with a higher quality opponent. That 103 rounds that he brings in, half of those rounds are quality rounds against quality unbeaten prospects. And even some of his losses, the loss to the guy in Northern Ireland, Jamie Conlan. I thought that he beat Conlan. I saw that fight. I thought Estrella deserved the decision. I call that a hometown decision for Conlan.
That was in September of 2014. He fought Jamie Conlan for the WBO Intercontinental title and lost the decision.
And that was a 10-round fight.
10-round fight in Belfast. Yeah, TJ guy ain't getting that call.
So he knows what it's like to be in enemy territory.
So India,
he knows what it's like to be the underdog. And he also knows what it's like to go 10 hard rounds. The Santamaro.
Santamaro has only gone past 6 once, and that was his last fight a couple years ago. Closing seconds of the round between Santamaro and Estrella. See some action from earlier in this fight.
Left a little bit under the belt line, but he keeps cranking the left, Estrella does, landing the left hook to the body to Santamaro. Santamaro trying to return fire on the inside. Does touch Estrella a little bit. Estrella landing the cleaner blows, however. Mixing his attack up to the body and the head. I think Rocco has to win this round if he wants any chance of even salvaging a draw. At least on my card, he needs several knockdowns or a knockout to win this fight.
Here we go, back into the sixth and final round.
The sixth and final round announced by ring announcer Joe Martinez, and they come out chucking him.
And Santamaro is doing exactly what he needs to do.
Steve Kim wants to get in there. Steve, how do you see it after five?
Well, I'm with Doug. I think he needs something dramatic, Santamaro. And that actually means a knockdown or two. I think four of the first five rounds, I think Estrella has won.
Estrella, the journeyman. It's Friday night. Forget your Netflix, boxing and chill. Order your shirts. And then you come out and you watch this fight on Ring TV Live.
I like what I'm seeing from Santamaro. Listen. Early in the fight, maybe he needed to pace himself, but now we're in the sixth and final round. I think he's way behind on the scorecards. He needs to make something happen. He needs to impose his size. And whatever strength he has left, he needs to impose it on the smaller man.
Good action fight between Rocco Santamaro and Jose Lamberto Estrella. Not Lamberto Quintero, but this is Hollywood Estrella.
Take a step back.
Estrella. Yeah, this is a fighter, and this is what I've learned from reading you and Steve over the years. You can never, ever judge a fighter by what the record is, or what they are, or where they come from, until you get into that ring. And Estrella right now doesn't look like the fighter who is the journeyman. Rocco Santamaro, in front of Steve and Doug's car, is in trouble right now. Not pressing the action.
Yeah, he needs to press. All 3 minutes of this round, he needs to press. He has just a little over 1 minute left. He needs to make this minute his. Santamaro needs to own this final minute.
They're talking to each other. Santamaro's like, come on, hit me more.
Love that. Good scrap.
Santa Moro has landed some quality punches. Estrella is in danger of being docked a point. He has strayed low several times.
Santa Moro takes a knee.
Yeah, that wasn't in TJ. That was from in Baja. That was a low blow.
From Baja to the Canadian Rockies?
Yeah, yes.
Referee Ray Corona calling him over with 34 seconds. That's been one of the things Ray's been telling him over and over, that pushing his head down. So let's see how the final 30 seconds of this fight shape up between Jose Estrella and Rocco Santamora.
I think Estrella's lucky that he wasn't penalized a point.
Let his hands go.
This is anybody's round.
Body shot from Estrella. Entertaining fight. Indio, California. A good Friday night. Thank you for joining us. Thank you to Rocco Santamora and Jose Estrella. Put on a good scrap. The final seconds of the sixth and final round. And another clash of heads. The second one. As Estrella came over, looked right at me in Spanish, said something that I don't think we see on the internet broadcast. It starts with no, it's finished with an M. And that'll do it. The fight is over. We'll go to the scorecards. It was rough.
Yeah.
That was a rough one. A couple of scraps, a couple of headbutts.
Good fight, though.
And Estrella. Good fun fight.
Yeah, good entertaining fight.
Go ahead, Doug.
He just liked the tweet. And there you see Rocco's had tomorrow with his trainer, Shane Mosley. Let's go to ring announcer Joe Martinez.
To the judges' scorecard, here are the totals. Both judges, David Dinkin and Fernando Villarreal, have it 59-55. Judge Pat Russell, 58-56. All for your winner by unanimous decision. And still undefeated, the SoCal Kid, Rocco Santamoro.
I agree with the crowd's reaction to that decision. Steve, I had it 4-2 for Estrella.
So did I. I thought it was 58-56. I thought rounds 3, 4, and 5 were relatively close, but I'm absolutely surprised that the two judges gave him one round. Huh.
And Estrella walked off the ring.
Yeah.
He gets an ovation from the crowd in front of the neutral corner. Matchmaker Robert Diaz walks over from Golden Boy, doesn't have either fighter under the sign, raises his hand and looks it to the crowd. We'll come back with more from Indio.